Jet with 229 people aboard exploded and crashed last night. The crash occurred about 25 minutes after the plane took off from Kennedy Airport. Fuel burned in the ocean all night as the Coast Guard searched for possible survivors. So far, no survivors have been found.
We're at a moment with Heidi Snow at our New York bureau. Heidi lost her fiancé in this TWA crash. How are you dealing with it, Heidi?
I fluctuate back and forth. And sometimes it's not real, and then it's real.
In the immediate aftermath of the crash, the American Red Cross, the airlines, and other organizations provided crisis intervention to the families and friends of the victims affected by this tragedy. But after only a few weeks, these disaster teams disbanded, leaving Heidi and the others with nowhere to turn. Devastated by what had happened, Heidi felt isolated and alone. She needed to find someone who understood, someone who had been through this type of tragic loss.
My name is Catherine Stefani, and I lost my daughter, Nicole Miller, on September 11th on United Flight 93.
My name is Betty Capasso, and my son, my 21-year-old son, Gregory, was on Pan Am Flight 103.
My name is Jeremy Umland, and I lost my brother, Eric, in a IFR training flight.
I lost my dad in a plane crash when I was 26.
I'm Mary Conklin. I lost my husband in a private airplane crash.
My name's Elizabeth Spooner Norton. I lost my dad, my mom, and my brother in a small private airplane crash.
My name is Liz Best, and I lost my husband on September 11th. We'd been married for 5 years, had a brand new daughter who was 11 weeks old at the time.
My initial reaction was just disbelief, absolute disbelief. How could this be happening? Yet I knew that it was real. And my husband was on his way home, and I remember screaming out the back door, Greggy's plane went down. Greggy's plane went down.
So I remember just calling him because I couldn't believe what was happening. And I think for the next couple of days, it wasn't real. I thought he would be safe or alive. Or I kept saying swimming the other way and just couldn't find land.
I felt like I was losing everything.
I lost my entire family, and as well, I lost my identity in that. It was gone.
I felt like I was grieving this loss of future life, you know, that I was supposed to share with somebody.
One of the things that became very apparent to me was that I needed to speak to other people who had been through this.
Heidi recognized the need for an organization that could provide long-term peer grief support to the victims and survivors of all air disasters. With the support of New York City officials such as Governor Pataki and Mayor Giuliani, as well as others affected by previous air crashes, Heidi founded Aircraft Casualty Emotional Support Services, ACCESS, in the fall of 1996.
Our Roma Torre introduces us to our New Yorker of the Week.
The mission of ACCESS is to provide ongoing peer grief support and referral services to people who have survived or lost loved ones in air crashes. ACCESS provides a place where people can come a year later. We have people from 2 years later who come and say, I need somebody to talk to who can relate to what has happened.
ACCESS also provides specialized sensitivity training and disaster preparedness workshops to airlines and other organizations around the world, including Air New Zealand, Qatar Airways, Southwest Airlines, JetBlue Airways, and the American Red Cross.
I contacted ACCESS about a year after my dad had died, in part because it wasn't until a year after he died that I really started processing the grief. And I found that the world was still moving on, but in some part I wasn't.
families who lost loved ones on Continental Flight 3407 are coming to terms with their loss. It can be a lonely and difficult process, but help is available.
It's a very hard loss.
Martha Ryan lost her husband, Kurt, in TWA Flight 800. She was devastated, but found comfort in a woman she met at the airport who had lost her husband in the Pan Am disaster of Flight 103.
For me, it was a lifeline at the time to get that emotional support from someone who had lost her husband and had survived.
Heidi Snow works to pair people who are coping with the unusual circumstances of losing a loved one on a plane crash.
As the disaster teams disbanded and we all had to go home and resume our lives is the time that I found to be most difficult. And because of that, I founded Access so that when the disaster site closes down, when people go home to resume their lives, they have a lifeline.
That was the whole thing for me, was I just kept feeling like I was really going downhill, and Access never quit.
Access has more than 250 trained volunteer grief mentors who have all been affected by air disasters. They provide immediate and long-term peer-to-peer bereavement counseling to over 1,000 individuals. The Access volunteers are available for as long as the grieving needs support.
We offer them comfort in knowing we were just like them.
What I find remarkable about Access is the peer-to-peer counseling. When I had my loss, there was no Access, and I recall clearly still really wanting to talk with someone who had shared a similar loss and I felt would really know what I was going through.
That's what Access is. That is built on that very foundation that someone who has been down that road and is further along than you has so much light to shed and can tell you so much about where you're going and how it feels and what it's going to feel like just by telling you what it was like for them.
6 years and I still cry, you know, and every day I go into my closet and I scream and I shout at the injustice of it all. But I think until you've gone through that, you don't understand that the pain does not go away. It gets different and it's not easy. It's a hard, long process that I think only people who have been through it can understand.
To have somebody who had been there before, it gave me hope. It gave me hope, huge hope, that life is out there.
Comfort.